Yeah, Manan, please make me as a host. Manan. Right.
जी, गिवन ऑप्शन।
Okay. Are everyone able to see my screen? Just reply in chat.
Harish sir, we could not able to see your screen. Kindly share. Yeah, now we can able to see screen.
Others are requested.
Kindly mute yourself.
Mute yourself. I repeat.
Mute yourself.
Till class end, please mute yourself and listen to the class. If there is any query or question, please unmute. Yes, your question, and then mute yourself so that class won't get disturbed. Now, today is our first technical session, is Introduction to Computers. Objectives of computers. Why computer literacy is vital to success in today's world? Why computer, knowing computer, accessing computer is important in today's world? Because computers and the internet have made the absolute best time in the history of the world to follow your passion. You can develop bonds for collaboration, and you can enhance and grow whatever you do through the power of the internet. We can read news, notifications online, using the internet to communicate with friends and family, apply for jobs, and for general participation in the world. And even computers are used to save the data, records or documents, pictures, etc. in a digital format. Define the term computer and describe the relation between data and the information. Computer, an electronic device for storing, processing data, typically in binary form, according to instructions given to it in a variable program. It takes input in binary format, like zeros and ones, and it processes that content and delivers the output. Describe five components of computer. Five components of computer are nothing but input unit, output unit, storage unit, central processing unit, CPU, arithmetic and logic unit, ALU, control unit, are five components of a computer. I repeat, input unit, output unit, storage storage unit, central processing unit, arithmetic and logic unit, ALU, control unit are the five components of a computer. What are the advantages and disadvantages while we use a computer? We will be knowing in further slides. And define the term network, identify the benefits of sharing resources on a network. One of the benefits of a network is that it allows group of computers or nodes to share data, share software, even share hardware such as printer, switch, scanner, etc. Most organizations that use many computers have them connected together as a network. Discuss the use of internet and World Wide Web. The internet carries an extensive range of information resources, services, such as the interlinked hypertext documents and applications on the World Wide Web, electronic mail, or in terms of telephony, or in terms of peer-to-peer network for file sharing.
Harish sir, sorry for interrupting. Okay. Kindly mute all students who attend this class while class was going. Don't unmute yourself. It will disappear.
Even after repeating couple of times, I see that you are unmuting yourself without any reason. The class will get disturbed. Please do check that you are under mute and listen to the class. If there is any query, unmute yourself, place your query, and then mute yourself. I'm repeating this. What are the differences between system software and application software? System software is meant to administrate the system resources, how the system hardware need to function. It also serves as a kind of platform for running the application software. On the other hand, application software is meant to enable the user to carry out some specific sets of tasks or functions. What are the different types and functions of computers in each category? Generally, sizes of computers determines the processing ability. Larger computers have higher processing speed, while smaller one offers the better experience for personal computing. There are types of computers used in solving complex mathematical computings, different types of computers and their functions, like supercomputers, mainframe computers, mini computers, microcomputers, likewise, where supercomputers are useful in server sites. Computers are everywhere. In today's life, a smartphone, tablet, laptop, desktop, we are using it everywhere digitally. A computer, definition of a computer. A computer is an electronic device operating under the control of instructions stored in its own memory. Instructions comes through input devices in the form of binary numbers, zeros and ones. And those instructions get processed and output will be derived. And the output which is derived, it comes in the form of a printout or it comes in the form of a application, whatever it is, the content what we are giving it, it comes in the proper output format. Like example, we are purchasing few things. We are purchasing few things. Those data is getting processed with the help of application, and we are getting a itemized bill. Whatever we have purchased from an outlet, we are getting a itemized bill. That is nothing but input, processing, and the output. A computer contains many electrical, electronic, and mechanical components inside a cabinet, which is, those are nothing but hardware devices. We are classifying it, input devices, which provides the input in the form of binaries, zeros and ones. Example, mic, keyboard, mouse, etc. are input devices. Output devices are speaker, printer, etc. are output devices, system unit, which contains electronic components of the computer and are used to process data, is nothing but system unit in which contains everything. Storage devices like hard drive, USB flash drive, or memory card, which comes under storage devices, which stores data in the form of bits and bytes, which will be converted into a picture or a voice or a music, video, etc. Communication devices enable a computer to send and receive instructions and information to and fro from one or more nodes. Like you see the examples of what are the input devices, what are the output devices. See here, printer, output device, optical disc, means DVD drive, output device, hard drive, storage device, monitor, output device, screen is also comes under output device, webcam comes under input device. See, these are the examples of input, output, communication device, which is modem, which creates a communication in between two systems, two users, or multiple nodes. Establishing a communication is nothing but a modem, which helps to establish a communication. External storage device, microphone, input device, etc. Advantages and disadvantages of computer. When we come to disadvantages of a computer, health risk. when we constantly sit on a computer and use computer constantly, then it will create a health risk. Violation of privacy and public safety means if we are keeping our personal stuff on social media platform and everything, whatever we are doing, day-to-day activities, if we are sharing it on a social platform, it will be on a risk. So need to think what need to be shared and what need not. Impact on labor force. For an example, if we take Amazon warehouse, which is located in US, where A to Z activities from order placed, order picked, packed, delivered, stamped, everything will be done by robots. So there is no man service over there. So impact on labor force, impact on environment. When it comes to environment, whatever the waste, hardware waste, need to be decomposed in a proper manner. If not, it will impact the environment. When it comes to advantages, speed. If you need to communicate with anyone through a voice or through video call, we can do that in minutes. Or if you need to place a letter, it will take 1 or 2 days to receive a letter. Reliability, consistency, storage. Previously, we used to store everything in hard copies. Now we can store data in digital format. Networks. A network is a collection of computers or nodes and devices connected together, often through wired or wirelessly, and a communication or transmission established. As you see in an image, a laptop is there, a desktop is there, a printer, and a server. A server and a laptop is connected through Wi-Fi, wireless communication. And when it comes to printer and a desktop, you will see a wired communication. The internet is a worldwide collection of networks that connects millions of institutions or individuals together. If you want to visit some XYZ site, just www.google.com, we will be able to log into the Google search engine, and whatever the content we want to search, we can search over there. And we are typing the name, host name, like Google, but at backend, there will be a IP address mapped to that website. We are not typing the IP address, we are just typing the name, domain name. With the help of that, we will be redirected to the site or the application or the institutions, whatever, wherever we want to connect. People use the internet for a variety of reasons, for online trading, for sharing info, for downloading music and videos, for communicating, for research and development, for shopping, banking, X, Y, Z. For many reasons nowadays, people are using internet. A social networking website encourages members to share their interests, ideas, stories, pics, music, videos with other registered users. A social networking platform provides you those features, and even live chat, live video calls you can do with the help of social sites. Software, also called a program, that tells the computer what tasks to perform and how to perform them. Means if there is an application or a program which will take the input, process that input, and gives the output. If the software is for an addition of numbers, if we are giving 2 plus 2 through a keyboard, 2 plus 2, it will take, a software will process that info, derive the output as 4. Installing is the process of setting up software to work with the computer, printer, and other hardware devices. If we want that output, the output what we have derived is 4, 2 plus 2 is 4. If we want it to be printed, printer need to be connected, we can just give the print. Whatever the software is there, we need to install that software in our system. It will work with the help of the operating system and derives the output. A programmer develops software or writes the instructions and directs the computer to process the data into information. Categories of computers. Personal computers, mobile computers and mobile devices, game consoles, servers, mainframe computers, supercomputers, embedded computers. A personal computer can perform all of its input processing, output and storage activities by itself. For example, when we take it as a desktop or a Mac notes. When it comes to mobile computer, examples are laptop, notebook, ultra thin book, tablet are the examples of mobile computer. When it comes to mobile devices, digital camera, portable media player, or hand-held computers, smaller smartphones are examples of mobile devices. You can see a notebook, how it will be tablet or smartphone or PDA devices, handheld computers, as you will be seeing those handheld computers mostly in the warehouses, likewise portable media players for playing music or videos, digital cameras. A game console is a mobile computing device designed to single or multiplayer video gaming like Xbox, etc., joystick. A server controls access to the hardware, software, and other resources on a network. When a server is installed, it will give limited access to the users. Application A, having access to 1 and 2 user. Application B, having access to 3 and 4 user. Printer access is having only to the 5th user. 1, 2, 3, 4, there is no access to the printer. 5th user, there is access to the printer. Those are the things which can be predefined in the server. Provide centralized storage for program, data, and information. Mainframe computers is a large, expensive, powerful computer that can handle hundreds and thousands of connection users simultaneously. What mostly will be used in IT sector industries, mainframe computers. Supercomputers are the data centers where data centers are established for bigger multinational companies. There they will be using those supercomputers. A powerful computers which processes more than 1 quadrillion instructions in single second. Embedded computer is a special purpose computer that functions as a component in a larger product. Embedded computing PICs. Hardware, software, data, people, procedures are involved, everything to process the data. When we see step one, IT staff develop the processing or a procedure for recording or checking the data received from the customer. A customer has sent some XYZ data to application A. Application A takes the inputs, employee fills that data into the software. That software connects to the server. Server has the application which processes the complete data which is has been filled by the employee, and it gives the output as from a printer resource. Examples of computer usages: there are home usages, small office usages, mobile users, etc. Computers are used in many sectors: education, finance, government, healthcare, retail, science, publishing, travel, manufacturing, many. Second chapter, components of the system unit. As you see the image in a cabinet, open cabinet, you will be able to see a motherboard, RAM, CPU, CPU cooler, graphic card, hard drive. System unit is a case or a cabinet that contains electronic components of the computer to use or to process data. This is a cabinet where all the hardwares are going to be installed. If you take a laptop, in laptop there will be RAM, hard drive, memory card, etc. Everything will be installed in it. If you take a phone, there will be a battery, power for power backup, there will be a display, there will be a memory, etc. installed in a phone device also. The inside of the system unit on a desktop, what it contains. See here, you are able to see sound card, video card, processor, RAM. This is nothing but a cabinet. And here is the place where we'll be installing the CD drives. And here is the place where you will be installing the hard drive. The motherboard is the main circuit board of the system unit. The computer chip contains integrated circuit. Here on a motherboard, you will be able to see a slot socket for placing a processor. And here are the slots where we'll be installing the RAM. Here are the slots where you will be installing the external sound card or external video card. These are the SATA ports where you will be connecting the hard drive, DVD drive from a SATA port. See, here is the complete image with the names of a motherboard. AGP card. Here you will be installing a graphic card. Here you will be installing an external LAN card or external audio card. Likewise, this is a CMOS battery, and here are the SATA, four SATA connectors, and here are four memory slots. This is a power connector, 24-pin ATX power connector. This is CPU socket where you will be placing the processor. This is back panel of input and output connectors on a motherboard. The processor, also called the central processing unit, interprets and carries out the basic instructions that operate a computer. The various types of processors are built in different architectures. There are two types of architectures, 32-bit architecture and 64-bit architecture. As you see in Windows XP, 32-bit, 64-bit, Windows 7, there is 32-bit and 64-bit architecture. When it comes to Windows 10, there is two flavors, 32-bit and 64-bit flavor. Likewise, it will be depends on speed and flexible capacity. The major types of CPUs are classified as single core, dual core, quad core, octa core, deca core, etc. See how a system process the content. If you take an input from a keyboard, it is taking an input, the data will be transferred in the binary form to the memory, RAM. From RAM, it will go to the processor. Processor takes the input, what it has received, and that input will be processed accordingly, what the data has received from the input in a binary form. It will process again, it will resend it to the memory. From memory, that information comes as a output format, whether it's a music, video, or picture, whatever it is, it will come as a output. It will go to the storage device if you are using any application which is stored on a system. So it will, from a memory, from processor, it will hit to the storage also, storage device. So it will take the application, what is the application is there, it will take accordingly, it will process and derives the output. The control unit is the component of the processor that directs and coordinates most of the operations in the computer. CPU, which coordinates most of the operations. The arithmetic logic unit, ALU, performs arithmetic comparisons and other operations. Here you see the explanation what I have given in a previous slide. For every instruction, whatever the instructions we are giving through with the help of a mic, input device, a keyboard, a mouse, whatever the inputs what we are giving, it process, repeat a set of four basic operations which compares a machine cycle. It goes to control unit, from control unit to the ALU unit, and then a display, it displays the output. If you are giving multiple instructions, before first instruction get finished, it will fetch second instruction. Before second instruction get finished, it will fetch third instructions. So we will get a constant output without any stoppage. The processor contains registers that temporarily hold data and instructions. Whatever, it will have a cache memory in processor. Whatever the instructions are going in, it will store it on a temporary basis till the task is accomplished. And everything will be calculated in system clock, controls the timing of all computer operations in gigahertz. Its speed will be calculated in gigahertz. The leading manufacturers of personal computer processor chips are Intel and AMD, are the two major names of manufacturers of processors. Here you will be able to see Xeon processor in for server processor, Itanium, Opton, Core i7 Extreme in Intel, Core i7 for desktop processors, Pentium dual core, Celeron, likewise Intel. Notebook processors, Core 2 Extreme, Core 2, are few examples of Intel and AMD processors. If you are going to purchase a new computer, desktop or a laptop, you need to think few basic things. What are going to be your day-to-day activities? What are you going to perform on it? Whether it is for simple browsing or whether it is you required for video or voice editing and all, CAD working, AutoCAD or civil. It depends on the application and usage. You need to define the processor and the RAM which you need to purchase. Here you will be able to see this is a heat sink. Above it there is a processor fan. And even this is a slot based process, external card. And below heat sink, there will be a cooling paste because processor is the one which gets heated up very quickly. To make it cool, a heat sink is placed. Below the heat sink, there is a cooling paste above the processor. And above that, there is a heat sink. Above heat sink, there is a processor fan. Parallel processing uses multiple processors simultaneously to execute single processor task. There are processors which processes multiple tasks simultaneously to derive the output. When we compare to servers, in servers there will be multiple processors, because number of user hits will be more. So they need to take a hit from a node or a user and need to process one by one, massive hits and derive the output and need to send to the XYZ users. As you see, the binary system uses two units, zeros and ones, bits and bytes. Data represents in bit and byte format. Whatever the inputs we are giving to the computer, it takes in the binary format, zeros and ones. Eight bits grouped together as a unit are called as byte. A byte represents a single character in the computer. So 8 bits is equal to 1 byte, which represents a single character. For example, you will see here, American Standard Code for Information Interchange, ASCII, is the most widely used coding scheme to represent the data. If you take, for example, H, binary format is 01001000, represents single character, single symbol is H. Likewise, if you press one H, 8 bits hits the processor. Then we will be able to see our output like display H. Here, taking the input, alphabet is T. It processes the input taken from the keyboard. After processing, binary code, which is 01010100. It processes, stores in the memory for processing. After processing, it's displayed on the screen as alphabet T. Memory consists of electronic components that stores instructions waiting to be executed by the processor, data needed by those instructions, and the results of processing the data. Okay, memory stores the data temporarily into its electronic components. Each location in memory has an address. Memory size is measured in kilobytes, megabytes, gigabytes, terabytes. Kilobytes denoted by KB, megabytes denoted by MB, gigabytes denoted by GB, terabytes denoted by TB. 1024 kilobytes is equal to 1 megabyte. Likewise, in multiples, it will come. Types of memory: volatile memory, non-volatile memory. Volatile memory means it will store the data temporarily when it comes to RAM. For example, volatile memory example is RAM. If we are logging to the desktop, we have opened a Paint application. To give faster access to that Paint application, that application is stored in RAM. As and when we restart the system or shut down the system, that application will be erased from the RAM. Means the application, whatever the application or web browsing, whatever we are using it, it will get temporarily stored in volatile memory. That is nothing but RAM. Non-volatile memory is nothing but CMOS battery, flash memory, or read-only memory, ROM. RAM is random access memory. ROM is read-only memory, where the data is fixedly, permanently written. You can only read the data from there. You can't do the editings. When it comes to CMOS, we can change the BIOS settings, but we can't change major settings. See here, memory, primary memory, secondary memory, and cache. When it comes to primary memory, you will be able to see a RAM, static RAM, dynamic RAM, ROM. There is PROM, EPROM, double EPROM. When it comes to secondary memory, there is hard disk, CD, DVD, magnetic or flash drives, etc. comes under secondary ROM. Cache is nothing but there will be a cache on a microprocessor also. DDR2 RAM, DDR3 RAM, DDR4 RAM, these are the bus speeds of RAMs, and these are the peak bandwidths. At maximum capacity, it is available. DDR2 available from 2 GB, 4 GB multiples. 6 GB, 8 GB, likewise DDR3 available in 4 GB, 8 GB, 12 GB, likewise DDR4 also available in 4 GB, 8 GB, 12, 16, likewise multiples. How program instructs transfer in and out of a RAM? Anything, if we want to access something which is stored on a hard drive, we will give instructions to our input device. It will hit the hard disk. Whatever the application we have installed, it will hit the hard disk. Take that with the help of operating system instructions, store that in a RAM, so that we can access it in a faster manner. Display that content or whatever the paint file or web browsing file, whatever we are accessing, it will display us on a screen. See, DRAM is nothing but dynamic RAM. SRAM is static RAM. DDR2 RAM is second generation RAM. DDR3 is third generation RAM. DDR4 is fourth generation RAM. Nowadays, what we are using is DDR4 RAM with different sizes and with different bus speeds. See, this is the RAM. And this is the RAM slot. Dual inline memory module, DIMM. We call it as DIMM. Memory slot. And you will be attending the practicals for this, where you can do the hands-on practice for installing of all the devices. See, what is the requirement of RAM? How we need to decide? If we are using some programs, 3D programming, graphic, CAD programming, then minimum 8 GB of RAM is required. No, if you are using it say simply for web browsing or for seeing videos, movies and all, then 2 to 8 GB is enough. Likewise, we need to define the RAM requirement. Memory caching, L1, faster access, L2, slower access, which will be stored in a processor chip for a time being, temporarily. It will be stored till it finishes the task. See, as I earlier explained, ROM, read-only memory, refers to the memory chip storing permanent data and instructions. PROM is nothing but programmable read-only memory chip, is a blank ROM chip that can be returned to permanently, where we can write the content permanently. Flash memory can be erased electronically and rewrite. Flash memory is nothing but our memory cards or some flash drives. CMOS technology provides high speed and consumes little power. We can do only CMOS changes, like a first boot device, second boot device, whatever the changes we want to do, whether a mouse is getting detected or not, whether the USB is enabled or disabled. Those are the settings, or time setting, system time setting. Those are the settings which we can do in CMOS. Expansion slot is a socket on the motherboard that can hold an adapter card. Adapter cards are example towards your right side in an image. Disk controller, SDTV tuner, modem, external modem card, external network card, or sound card, etc. If you want extra USB ports, so we can place an extra card on a PCI slot. Few cards are plug and play. For example, you are seeing a card which is placed in a CPU. For few, we need to install the drivers, and few will take a plug-and-play drivers and start working. Removable flash drives or thumb drives are nothing but memory cards. A port is the point at which peripherals get attached, like USB or PS2, mouse, keyboard get connected to get further communicate. See here, this is a PS2 port, and these are the USB 3 ports. Here a VGA connector. Here this is a serial port connector where we use to connect a modem for communications. Line in, line out, and mic. Parallel port for connecting dot matrix printers or billing printers for parallel port. RJ45 jack port, sorry. USB 2 ports. HDMI port. See here, the same way on a motherboard. Serial port, USB ports, a keyboard and mouse. Blue color, PS2, defines to keyboard. Green color, PS2, defines to mouse. DVI or HDMI port. This is a external graphic card where we can connect a monitor which is having a DVI port option or a HDMI port option for graphical output, high definition output. See, these are the ports which we will be able to see on a laptop. Modem port, RJ45 port, charging port, audio in and out. Nowadays, for latest laptop, there is a single port for in and out. But previously, they used to be separate for mic and separate for headset. HDMI port, USB ports. Here you will be able to see a different types of ports and their images. HDMI port, audio in, cable TV, headphone, serial port, monitor port, which will be used for displaying on a monitor, DVI port for graphic card. Connectors, type A, type B, and mini B, USB connectors. Normally what we are using is type A USB connector. Here you will be seeing a box type connector, type B, which we will be using it for connecting printers, mostly printers, scanners, and mini B, where we will be using it for DVD writer or mobile devices with the help of game consoles, will have mini B connectors. As you have seen earlier only, the types of other connectors, flash drive, memory drives, a Bluetooth wireless port adapter converts a USB port into a Bluetooth port. This is a thumb drive where we will be using a cordless keyboard and mouse to connect the laptop or a desktop. So with the help of this thumb drive, we can connect wireless devices, keyboard, mouse, etc. through Bluetooth connectivity. This is a docking station where you will be having extra ports, LAN port. It depends on the type and model. It will have USB ports, LAN port, memory card reader, etc. It will get HDMI port, etc. It depends the type of docking station you are using to connect extra devices, type C port, etc. See, a bus allows various devices, both inside and attached to the system unit, to communicate with each other: data bus and address bus. These are the slots where you will be installing the cards. Front panel of a CPU. Here it's showing you a card reader place, optical drive for placing your floppy or DVD drives. Here there are ports for USB connection ports, and here there are the ports for your input output devices like mic, speaker, headset, etc. to get connected. The power supply converts the wall output AC power into DC, SMPS, whatever is installed in our system will convert AC power into DC power, and then it will supply that power to the motherboard. From motherboard it will get divided. See, depend on the usage of a user, we need to decide the RAM or the processor what we require. While cleaning the desktop, we need to maintain a safest distance, and we should not use the blower with a constant speed, or a motherboard will get flash up. Yeah, if you are having any doubts, you can raise your queries now.
Assalamu alaikum, sir.
Wa alaikum assalam. One by one, please put your question. Mute yourself.
Myself, Azimuddin. Sir, can you please share this PDF in our group?
Yeah.
So that we can revise.
Yes, yes. We will be sharing you the link in the WhatsApp group. Through that link, you will be able to see the video.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Okay. Anything else?
No, sir.
Okay.
Thank you.
Others are having any doubts?
No, sir.
Okay.
Sir, another one. What is that PDA full form, sir? Program?
Which full form?
You have said in while explaining, you have said one of.
In one of the
PDA
slides,
full form.
PDA.
Yes, sir.
Next question, I will be answering you. PDA are the a personal digital assistant device, also known as handheld PC. Mostly you will be able to see in warehouses, some heavy kind of a thing. When Blue Dart courier service person will come now, Blue
yes,
Dart
sir.
And FedEx courier persons, they will be having some big devices on the display devices.
Yes, sir.
Those devices
like
are
iPad.
Not iPad. iPad is something different. PDA devices, where they will be having a simple program, only that they can use. They can't listen music or some XYZ things in that. Only work related okay. tasks they will be able to do. Personal
okay,
digital assistance, PDA, handheld PC. Next,
Hello, a very good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, sir.
What is the latest processor we are using right now, sir?
Right now, there is 10th generation i3, 10th generation i5, 10th generation i7.
Okay. And about the RAM, sir, how it would be like a very speed or which we need to prefer most if we go in a market and we want a RAM speed?
It purely depends on the requirement for what. If you are purchasing a laptop or a desktop, for what we are purchasing, what we are going to perform. Those are the things we need to put down on a paper first.
Okay, sir.
Then we need to decide which type of processor or what is the RAM storage we need to require, or a hard disk, whether we need to go for HDD or whether we need to go for SSD.
One more question, sir. Mostly, sir, we use a Windows 7, sir. Why? Because, sir, okay. Why the Windows 6 and 8? Why we not use this, sir? Mostly, when you go for in every way, sir, Windows 7 is preferable.
See, listen, Windows XP, still now, Windows XP, there are systems and the offices where they are using Windows XP. There are offices where they are using Windows 7. Windows 8, no, very less, because it has not gained that much popularity. And immediately,
like, sir, why so it has been released. Gained.
And immediately tell me.
Sorry for interruption, sir. Why we use the Windows 7 most preferable, sir? What are the like advantages in the Windows 7 than the Windows 8, sir? Would like to know, sir.
Okay.
Sir, rather than, sir, we can use a various software, no, sir. Why we using the Windows only, sir? Can I get to know this, sir?
Yeah, because Windows is having GUI interface which is user friendly. Okay, when it comes to Mac, it will be a bit difficult. It will take time to get access or user friendly on a Mac system. But when it comes to Windows operating system, it is most easily, GUI interface is most easily, and it can be accessible. And most of the applications are compatible with Windows when it comes to Mac. Won't. And Mac is having restrictions.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Next question.
Assalamu alaikum.
Walaikum assalam.
Can you explain me detailly for CMOS?
CMOS? Yeah, you will be doing a practical of changing the settings, how you need to enter into the BIOS CMOS, and what are the things will be there. I have briefly explained you now. Whether a USB device is not working. Okay. Device is working fine on another system, but when we are connecting on a laptop, USB keyboard is not working. When you are connecting the same keyboard to the B desktop, it's working fine. So whether there is a problem in a port or there is a BIOS setting where the USB port is disabled, that you will be checking down in practicals. We will be scheduling the practicals on Saturday. That intimation you will be getting it. And you have to attend the practicals. There you will be knowing the BIOS settings or hands-on.
Okay, thank you.
Walaikum assalam.
I need to ask something. So by physical view of RAM, how can we identify generation?
There is a voice disturbance.
Okay.
Please put down your question in chat. Till then, okay. Any question from others? Any more questions? Yes, someone is asking question related to RAM. Please put down your question. How can we identify the RAM?
Yes, sir. I'm having a doubt, sir, regarding that, sir.
Yeah, I have shown you in a pic, na, in images, how to identify a RAM. It will be look like a scale. Okay, na? Scale.
Sir, yes.
It will be look like a scale, and there will be a cut in between of a RAM. And you will be seeing in practicals how there are different types of DDR2 RAM, DDR3 RAM, DDR4 RAM. You will be able to see and how to install it also. Any more questions?
Sir, my question was not the physical RAM. We need the information how to identify the generation of RAM.
Generation of RAM, how to identify it?
Yes,
okay,
yes.
It depends on the RAM. If we keep 3 to 4 different types of RAM, the cuts, there will be a cuts below the RAM.
Yes.
U-type cut. Depending on that, you need to identify whether it is a DDR2, DDR3 or DDR4.
Okay.
Okay, as well as there will be a sticker placed on it. Looking onto it, or seeing the motherboard, you can try to figure out whether it's a DDR2 RAM or DDR3 or DDR4 RAM.
Oh. Unless and until we can check the motherboard and RAM physically,
yeah,
after the physical situation, physical view, we can able to identify or we can differentiate the generation.
If you want to see the capacity, you can see the capacity by clicking on my computer icon, this PC, right click, properties. There you can see whether it is a 4GB RAM or 2GB RAM, you can see that. If you want to know whether it is a DDR, you need to enter into the BIOS.
Yes.
Then you can see whether it's which DDR RAM.
Instead of going inside the application while touching the physical equipment, as soon as we touch the equipment, how to find out which generation it is, either 2 or 3, as you said. Instead of going into the application or seeing the physical view on the digital side, touching this equipment, RAM, is it a DDR2?
If you are purchasing a branded CPU, from a brand X, from a brand Y, branded CPU, not assembled one. If you see that, you can say that it is having a DDR3 RAM, it is having a DDR4 RAM. You can say that by seeing a CPU. But if it is a branded CPU, but you can't say whether it is having a 4GB RAM, whether it is having a 8GB RAM, until and unless you are having a proper info of that model.
By seeing the outline only, by seeing the outline instead of going inside,
yes.
Is it a DDR3 or DDR4 by physical handling?
Yeah, I'm telling you now, if you have purchased a branded CPU of X brand, if
yes.
you see that, you can just say that, yeah, it is having a DDR3 RAM. Yes, you can say by seeing few models, yeah, it contains a DDR4 RAM. For that precision, you need to have some experience, working experience.
Oh.
Okay, to identify.
Yes, yes, okay.
To identify it, only you can say, yeah, it contains a DDR4 RAM, maybe probably it is having a DDR3 RAM. That you can say by seeing a CPU. If it is a branded CPU.
Okay. Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Any more questions?
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, how we can use two operating system in a one PC, sir?
Yes, you can.
How it is applicable, sir?
By virtual machine, you can use that. With the help of virtual application, you can use that. But before using, you need to see the compatibility. What is the primary OS you are having? What is the hard disk? What is the RAM you are having inside your system? Depending on that, what is the second OS you are installing, or else it won't work properly. You will get issues. Next.
Okay, sir.
Any more questions? So should I end the class? Please reply in chat. If there are no questions, I'm going to end the class.
Sir, someone has
written. No questions, madam.
Suppose we troubleshoot a system, how do we identify that RAM it is if the system is off? Yeah, as I have mentioned, you need to open the cabinet and check what is the RAM it is. Or if it is a branded CPU, you can guess what is the RAM it is having. For example, if you want to identify a car, whether it's a Indica or i10 or i20, seeing a back for each and every car, the back panel, the lighting design will be different. You need to memorize that back panel headlights, how they are, for i10 how it is, for i20 how it is, for Indica how it is. Then with a far distance also you can say that, array, that is Audi, array, this is i20. You need to identify. It comes under experience only. Just you can say that, yeah, it contains DDR3 RAM or DDR4 RAM, but you can't say whether it is a 4GB or 8GB. Next.
Okay, sir, thank you.
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, I'm having one personal question, sir. If you give me permission, sir, can I, sir?
Okay.
Sir, actually, I'm opening my CPU, sir.
Okay.
And the CPU is under on.
One minute. You can. You can place your question to Mannan. He will forward it to me and I will answer it. Okay.
Sure, sir.
Next. Any more questions? If there are no questions, just reply in a chat so that I can end the session. And those who are attending the theory classes are only allowed to attend practical classes. And if you are going to miss one practical class, there will be no repetition of practical class and no online video of practical class. Do remember.